Hello everyone, welcome to Fun Scholars e-learning portal, and I'm Ramajan, and today in this video we'll be discussing about LEDs.
Alright, so what is an LED?
LED is an electronic device and the full form of LED is light emitting diode.
Alright, so what it is? It's light emitting diode.
So now with this full form, what it is? A diode which actually emits or which is capable of emitting light, that is known as LED. Now the first question arises, why we need an LED when we already have several types of lamps? It involves the basic fluorescent bulb. Let's say what kind of bulb it is, like the construction is very simple, right? This is how a typical bulb looks like. So what happens? It's basically a filament or a simple wire which once given a supply, it gets heated up, this filament, and it illuminates light. Alright, this is how a typical bulb functions. But what happens? Let's say the 100% energy whatever we are providing, the only 5% of this energy is getting transformed into light, and the rest 95% is wasted in heat. So it's very much ineffective. So that's why we need certain mechanism in which the efficiency is more, because here the efficiency is very low. So that is why this concept of light emitting diode came into picture. So what happens in LED? So a typical LED or light emitting diode consists of two specialized semiconducting material. Now in about this semiconducting material we will be discussing later, but for now just remember this. This is a combination of two specialized semiconducting material, and inside it certain reaction happens once we are providing a electrical supply. Alright, and the moment we provide a voltage, so here a process that is known as electroluminescence. So this process, using this process, this actually is capable of emitting light. So that's what simply happens. Now there are several factors which we must understand as far as the working of LED is concerned. So there are V, or the voltage that is called forward voltage, or we denote it as with VF. So this forward voltage, actually the threshold voltage which is required to generate the light. Alright, to activate this so that electron flows from this side to that side and it is capable of generating light. So that is called the forward voltage. Okay. So what are the advantages of using this LEDs? So first of all, the energy efficiency. I mean, the amount of energy or the voltage will provide, it almost, 5% is getting wasted in heat. In case of this, more than 90% to 95% of energy is converted into light. So thus, it's very effective. And the second thing is its durability. It's actually on a single run, it can work up to 10 years. So this is a huge thing, right? And apart from this, so there are several electronic, small electrical appliances in which we can use it very much. And there is a large scale applications are also there. So in case of street lights, torch, in case of, heavy electronic circuits also, in various appliances, in automobile sectors, everywhere we can use these things. Okay, so these are the basic applications of LED and the advantages. Alright, so now how you are going to distinguish an LED and use in a circuit, that is also very important to know, right? So typically LED looks like this. So this side is kind of flat surface and this is kind of round surface. So this is actually how you are going to know that this LED is, which side of the LED is positive or negative. So to define that, the longest or the longer portion of this terminal, this is the positive terminal, and the smaller one is the negative terminal. Okay, and if suppose sometimes it's almost parallel, then how you are going to know that which one is positive and which one is negative? So the one which is having the edging or edge, the flat surface, this is in positive and this one is negative. Okay, or we denote it with anode and cathode. So this is my anode and this is my cathode. Alright. So anode is positive and cathode is negative. Alright. So when we give a supply, let's say positive terminal is connected with the positive terminal of the battery and the negative one is with the negative terminal. So if we do so, will it work? What's the answer? Just think it once. Yeah, it can work, but it depends how much force or how much voltage you are applying. If the voltage is more than the sustainability of this particular LED, then this will blow off. So for that purpose, we must use certain or such an element which can resist the electricity. So that is what is a resistor, which we need to talk obviously, and we'll discuss it in later sections. So for now, so this is all about the LED. Alright, so I think you were able to understand what I've said till now. So let's go for a recap. So what happens in the conventional lights, there most of the energy is converted into heat, and so the efficiency is very less. In case of LED, the energy efficiency is very high. So efficiency for LED is high. Alright, and there are several applications of LEDs, like in various electrical appliances, whether it is a small scale or is a large scale, or in automobile sectors, everywhere LEDs are now very much useful. What's the third point? It's the durability. So it can last up to 10 years at a single run. Alright, and the fourth point that is very useful, the voltage, the forward voltage. That plays the important role. Unless the threshold voltage matches for an LED, it is not capable of generating the light. And it is made of a combination of two semiconducting materials, such as gallium arsenide or all these things. Okay, so it's actually made of two combined or combination of two semiconductors. Alright. And typically, LED functions in around 20 milliamps of current. In 20 milliamps of current, it actually functions. Alright. So, this is what is about LED. So, in the later sections, we will be discussing about resistance, because resistance actually plays the crucial part to limit the current. So, we must need to understand what is resistance. So in this later section, we'll be discussing about that. Thanks for watching. Till then, keep learning and keep having fun. Thank you.